The Social Security System looks to expand its portfolio in the real estate investment trust space. The state insurer has so far invested some 6 billion pesos in REIT companies this year. SSS officials expect the move to yield better returns for the agency. Its bullish outlook on growth in REIT investments is anchored mainly on the expected rate cut by the central bank this year and what it cited as increasingly favorable market conditions. Scores of workers of the Sofitel Philippine Plaza urged the management of the renowned Pasay Hotel to retain their jobs ahead of its looming closure. This, as they claim, the impending closure of the hotel is only temporary, alleging the establishment will reopen after renovations to address safety concerns. They assert the closure is a way for the hotel to dissolve unions.
Ikinagulat po ng mga manggagawa po yung kanilang binitawang salita. Bagamat ang opinion po ng union ay hindi po to pagsasara kundi ay isang renovation lamang po.
Ito lamang po yung pinagkukuhanan namin ng aming buhay po, pang-araw-araw. Napakasakit po na ibinigay namin yung aming buhay dito. Bigla na lang po kaming tatanggalin ng ganun-ganun na lang po. Masakit po sa amin yun.
Meanwhile, the management of Sofitel dismissed these allegations and affirmed its commitment to assisting their soon-to-be displaced workers in finding new jobs. Credit reporting agency calling for a consistent financial education among Filipinos amid the rise of digital transaction fraud in the Philippines. This remark from TransUnion Philippines comes after it found 8.3% of all digital transactions in the country last year were suspected to be digital fraud. That figure is higher than the global average of 5%.
Action has to be taken cohesively at an institutional level as well as obviously at a consumer level. At a consumer level, the approach has to mean consistent and continuous efforts in terms of financial awareness, the right and safe banking practices, right? And this is again cohesively requiring all of us to be doing this. From an institutional standpoint, like I mentioned previously, this would also entail the right choices of data visibility that you're investing in, the right layers in terms of information security and technology and tools that you're investing as well. So this will create a very safe environment because clearly, in terms of future trends that we're expecting, as transactions are bound to rise, we also have to brace for some of these anomalies to happen. So therefore, these variances are bound to happen. It's about the steps we do to mistake-proof and create a very safe environment.
Mexico has elected its first female president. Poll officials have declared Claudia Sheinbaum as the winner of the presidential election. Exit polls show Sheinbaum won a landslide 56% of the vote, while opposition candidate Xochitl Galvez got 30%. Galvez has conceded to Sheinbaum. This year's elections was marred by violence. 38 candidates were killed in the lead-up to the polls, while two were killed during voting in Puebla State. Sheinbaum will be tasked with confronting organized crime violence in the country, brought by warring drug cartels. She will begin a six-year term on October 1st.